Hi friends, this is Momita Mukherjee Chatterjee. Welcome to my another video from my YouTube channel. Hope you guys like my video. So share, subscribe and like my videos as usual. And this is part 2 from the genetics chapter where I supposed to discuss about the monohybrid cross and the so on. So thank you. So stay tuned with my video. Thank you. So firstly we'll talk about number one, we'll talk about the genome. Genome, what we are talking about, in a single set of chromosome, the gene which are located or the contain in a single, we know these are the two chromosome. So in a single set of chromosome, whatever gene are present, these are mainly called the genome. So the genome is that particular gene that containing in a single set of chromosome is called the genome, right? So number two, we have to know about the pure line and the hybrid one. So firstly we'll talk about the pure line. So pure line, what actually the pure line is? The pure line is that particular plant or animal population, plant or animal population which all have the homozygous origin of parent. Okay, so there is no mixing of character, no mixing, right? So there is no mixing of character. We are considering them as the pure line. And what about the hybrid one? The hybrid one is that particular group where crossbreed kind of thing we are finding. Kind of thing means we can talk about all the plants and animal, this all are originated from various type of crossbreeds. Okay, so in case of the hybrid we are talking about the crossbreed, but like the mixing of character, mixing of characters we are finding in case of the crossbreed. And in case of the pure line, the plants and animal population, these all are from the homozygous origin, is called the pure line. Okay, so now we have to know about the next one, that is the autosome and the sex chromosome. So what is autosome? Autosome and the sex chromosome, this is the next one what we are supposed to discuss. In case of the autosome, we all know the autosome, the chromosome, in case of the autosome, this all are the chromosome that having in a equal in number, that are found in the equal in number in case of male as well as the female, right? So in case of the autosome, suppose I am giving example, like we human, if we are giving example of human, we all know that we have autosome 22 pairs, right? So this 22 pairs are equal for male and female, that's why this is called the autosome. Okay, and this is the sex chromosome which are not similar. In case of male and female, the sex chromosomes which are not similar as it is called the sex chromosome. They are morphologically dissimilar, right? X and Y. Okay, so regarding this X and Y, we all know this Y is the particular chromosome which is mainly determine the male character. So in case of female, we know it is XX, and in case of male, it is XY. Clear? So these chromosomes are called the sex chromosome because these two are morphologically not similar, and definitely they are the determining chromosome which characters define, like the male and the female. These characters are determined by this sex chromosome. Clear? So now we are going to the next part, which is the Mendel and his work. Clear? So hope you guys are like my video. So like, share and subscribe my video. So first we'll talk about the Mendel's work. Mendel has taken the garden plea, it's called the Picum sativum, right? So the reason, what is the reason behind this Picum sativum? There are so many reasons. One we can talk about, it is easily available. Obviously. Number two, there are various type of tolerance, like the plant can extreme environment tolerance, extreme tolerance. They can. Number three, self-pollinating. This is very important. Pollination means no mixing of character, right? There are some more reasons we can talk about. They have short life, so it is very easy to culture generation after generation. And we can talk about, there are the features are seen easily. So these are the basic reasons. These are the basic reason for choosing this garden pea or Picum sativum. So first we'll see about the characters that Mendel has taken for this garden pea. The first one, we know there are 7 pairs of character. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So there are mainly 7 pairs of characters according to this Mendel work, where the stem height. We all know there are 2 consecutive part. One is the pure one, which is called the dominant one. And this is the recessive character, what we are talking about. The tall, respectively, the dwarf is the recessive one. The flower position, where the flower will be, either at the axial end or at the terminal end, that also matters. The seed shape, the shape of the seeds, they may be round, they may be wrinkled. The seed color may be yellow or green. We all know the color, red color written is the dominant character, what I am showing it here. The violet is the flower color, and respective the recessive trait is white. The pod shape is inflated and constricted. The pod color green or yellow. So these are the characters which we can talk about, the dominant character as well as the respective recessive character. We know the allele in my previous video. In the description box, you can see the link over there. I have given that the dominant and the recessive character, what they are. So, uske upar depend karke hum log ye 7 pairs of character from the Mendel selection. These are the character this has been taken for the garden pea. Okay. So, now we have to know the most importantly, that is the monohybrid cross. Clear? So, according to the Mendel, the monohybrid cross is that particular cross. It is between 2 organism or between the plant or animal, that depends. The characters are selected by the Mendel. It's a single trait of character. That is why it is called the monohybrid cross, right? It's monohybrid. So let's see how he has performed the monohybrid cross. Mendel has taken the pea plant and he has taken the standard character, that is the plant height. Just now we have seen in the plant height there are capital T and small t. That means the T is the dominant one and the small t is the recessive character. So what is the character? The height is the tall and this is dwarf. So these are the 2 character or 2 respective alleles present on a chromosome for determining the height of the plant. So Mendel has chosen that particular plant which is the pure line. Generation after generation, he performed his action to find out the pure line, and he finally find this particular trait. So he considered as the parental generation, or we can talk about the P generation. Okay, so in the P generation, he has taken the pure tall plant and pure dwarf plant. So what about the genotype? The genotype will be capital T and small t, right? So in between them, he find out the gamete. So what gamete we are finding? From there, the common gamete we are finding, that is capital T is the gamete, and here the common gamete, that is small t is the gamete. So after the isolation of the gamete, the simple mixing of character, or we are finding capital T, small t. This capital T, small t, this particular individual or this particular plant is showing the tall plant. So what tall we can talk about? This tall is not the homozygous one. This is the heterozygous tall. In my previous video, we have discussed about homozygous and the heterozygous. So see the description box and you can find out detail about the homozygous and the heterozygous, right? So now we have to know this result we are talking about. It is the first filial generation or F1 generation. So after that, what he performed, he had seen in a multiple experiment that the result of the F1 generation, he is getting that the same result. So what he has performed, he has done the selfing. Selfing means there is another culture medium, वहाँ से भी the same, he found the same thing and he performed the selfing in between, or you can talk about the cross pollination in between this two particular organism. So just see in the F2 generation what he will found. Before that, we can find out the gamete. So the gamete will be like that. From here, capital T, small t, and from here also the capital T and the small t. So these are the two particular gamete he found. So these are the two gamete he found from there. Clear? So now we are performing the next function. Let's see what result we are finding in the next generation. So let's see. A concept called the Punnett square or checkerboard, we have to find it out. So in the F2 generation, we are finding the result like that. There is a Punnett square or the checkerboard. This is completely practical oriented. It's a completely theoretical oriented. It's not the practical oriented, it's the theoretical oriented. So where we are keeping the gamete, capital T, small t, and here capital T, small t. So just see, capital T, small t, capital T, small t, small t, small t. So it's a only the cross between. इसके साथ ये, इसके साथ ये, इसके साथ ये, इसके साथ ये. Okay? So these are the result what we are finding. So let's see the genotypic result or the gene we are finding, the types. The first type we get capital T, capital T. The second type we get capital T, small t. And the third type we get small t, small t. देख लेते कितने number capital T तो है, that is 1. The small t, that is 2. And the capital T, this one is capital T, small t. And this is small t, 1. Okay. So the character wise we are finding, this is pure tall or the homozygous tall. these two are the heterozygous and this is the homozygous. So this is the result of our genotype. And the what about the phenotype? The phenotypic result will be this three. All are, even this three, all are tall. So they are tall. And this is the only one. That small t, this is dwarf, right? So this will be the ratio like that, 1 is to 2 is to 1. This is what we are talking about, the genotypic ratio. And the phenotypic ratio will be, what will be the phenotypic ratio? That 3 is to 1, clear? So this is the result of the monohybrid cross according to the Mendel. Now the last thing we have to know, that do remember the monohybrid cross is not perform only the plant. In guinea pig also Mendel has taken the example, like we can talk about in guinea pig. The coat color or the seed color, the mainly he has taken that is very commonly known as the black, which is the pure one, and the white sheet coat. From there also he got the phenotypic ratio, it's 3 is to 1, and the genotypic ratio is 1 is to 2 is to 1, clear? So from there the law of segregation, this law used to talk about that the characters are not mixing of character. Though we know that the dominant and the recessive, the gene or the characters are not mixed with each other. They are simultaneously present, separately they are present, and according to the need, they are making a particular trait which is not the mixed character. Like in F1 generation, we have seen that the capital T, small t, they are located side by side, but there is no mixing of characters. So the law of segregate, mainly the first law we are used to talk about from the Mendel first monohybrid cross. वहाँ पे वो दिखाने वाले थे, the characters or the genes are present side by side, there is no mixing of character, though they are sitting together or they are present together side by side. Okay, so this is the law of segregation. So in my next video we'll come to know about the next thing, about the second law as well as the various type of law which is very important. Thank you.